Hi, Mimi.
Hi.
The whole experience of meeting the British kids is amazing. Like, they're so adorable and they're so professional when it comes to acting.
I get along with them. They're such incredible people. They're so much fun to be around all the time.
They're amazing. They're really fun, really energetic.
I'm to the Rwandan Genocide Memorial Center in Rwanda, and so I really got to understand how it was during that time.
My Rwandese friend, who was Tutsi, lost half her family in the Rwandese genocide, and her family, some of them, very few, survived, and they lived in Rwanda in such hard times, and I found it very inspiring to talk to them and to understand what exactly some people went through.
It's based on Lizzie's experience of how she lived as an NGO in those refugee camps.
It was very tough to see it, and I met actually one of the women who had lost her children, and she told the story of how she had lost her children, and just seeing that, it really did put everything in perspective, and I kind of did take on like her experiences and put it into my acting when I came to play Esperance in the play.
The people playing the main part, they act it out so well that it actually makes it so real.
It made me feel sorry for all those people back in 1994 in the refugee camps who had run from their home.
I have like quite a hard time trying to express all the pain and like the anger and like the grief that they must have felt. Because like everyone else is a bit more happy and like they're running around singing songs, but I'm a bit more like angry and upset with the situation. And just on stage, it's a bit of a challenge, but I enjoy it.
It seems like so unreal is so hard that it can't possibly be real, but it is.
I think the most dramatic part of the play is when Haki dies. Mm. Like that's like the main focus. That's the part that touches me the most. Because he tries to do everything to help his sister out, and then all of a sudden everything goes down.
It's important that as many people know about the story and like the message that it spreads, the message of hope.
And it also made me realize how tough life can be on you. But sometimes good things can come out of all that toughness.
It's got a very good message in it, that you've always got to hope for the future.
The main character, Esperance the name, means hope.
I read this book called Left to Tell, and it's about the Rwandan genocide and about a woman, how she discovers and how she managed to survive during the Rwandan genocide. And so that was also really encouraging to see how she was uplifted from such a horrible situation.
If we spread the message, like charity can get more money, which would help all the refugee camps.
It goes to a really good cause, and it makes people... It makes people feel happy. It makes them probably feel somebody else actually again, who they used to be.
I think it'll really give people a broad perspective on everything. It'll make kids understand that life isn't so simple all the time and life isn't so easy.
Those who do not learn from history are doomed to repeat it.
If children don't learn about it and people don't learn about it, then they can't grow up and try and change it and make things better in the world.
There's more to you than just, you know, sitting around, going to school, that you can actually do much more with your life and that you can really persevere through a lot of things.
They brought themselves together to protect each other, which showed the true strength of the human spirit.
If we can get awareness out about such happenings of mass killings, it could stop or prevent something in the future.
Yeah. Less mistakes.
Well, it was a really good show, and I actually wish I could be watching it as well as performing in it, because I really want to see what all the bits I'm in are like.
I get very nervous on stage, but I don't know, there's something that when I'm on stage I feel alive and enthusiastic to get a message across.
The story behind it is really interesting and inspirational.
That huge round of applause and a standing ovation we got made most of us feel that we had done a really, really good job.
I think when I grow up I want to be someone who helps, or I might want to work in a refugee camp maybe, because it must be really hard for people, and to have someone there looking after them must mean a lot to them.
It's important to spread the message, and it's a really nice, fun show to learn, so it's a good way of learning what's happening, because you don't really even know that you're learning it until you've watched it and you're like, whoa, that was really good.
I remember a time the way Miss Rusbach was joking about it, saying, oh, we'll tell the story to the whole world. And then now, 3 years later, we're here in London performing it, and it's just an amazing experience.